Good day everyone and welcome back to BFA 501. In this video, we are going to learn about SQL conditional clause, or also known as SQL where clause. So from the previous video, we already knew about select and from keywords. Select always followed by the name of the column that you want to see or we want to get. From always followed by the name of the table where the data is stored. And then we will add one more keyword here, which is where keyword. Where will be followed by condition. Okay, the main idea about conditional clause or where clause is to show the data from a table which match certain condition. Okay, and multiple condition can be combined using two logical operator. There are a couple of logical operator here. And the second one is or. Okay, and then there are several conditional operator or logical operator that we can use. The first one is equal, not equal, greater than, less than, greater or equal, less than or equal, between, like, and in. I will give some of the example later. So we're gonna try the very simple example over here. So in this case, select from where. So the sequence have to be like this: select first, second one is from, and the third one is where. From always followed by the name of the table. Select always followed by the name of the columns. Can be one, can be more. The columns name that we want to get or we want to see from the table. Okay. So in this case, from cells, it means that we want to get the data from the cells table. And then select cells date, product CD or product code and unit price. It means that from cells table, we want to get cells date, product code and unit price. Okay. And then where unit price greater than 5.0, we want to get only the data that has unit price greater than 5.0. Okay, let's jump to the tote and I will make a new one here. Just click edit. Oh, make sure we already connected with our database. Okay, I will show you the example now in a second. So in this case, select from. Okay, just do it. Select from first. Okay. From cells. Okay. Sometimes it's easy to think from first, like from cells. It means we want to focusing on the cells table here. Okay, and then cells date, and then product code, and then unit price. Okay, so if I only do it like this, it means that I will get the whole data, okay, all record or all rows from table cells, and I want to get column cells date, product code and unit price. Okay, but it means that I will get the whole row in table cells. And this is where clause is came. So I will remove this one. I will put where. If I only want to get unit price that greater than 5 only, so I need to make a condition here. Unit price greater than 5.0, for example. Then semicolon. Semicolon is used to end or in the end of all SQL statement. And then in this case, you only see all the data that has unit price greater than 5.0. There is no more data which has unit price less than 5.0. Okay, so we will continue with the next Example, for example, in this case is I want to see the product code from table products that has flavor egg bacon. So you select from, okay, from table products. Okay, sometimes, as I mentioned before, sometimes it's easier to work from clause first and go to the select. I want to see product code and flavor, for example. Okay, if I execute like this, okay, I will see the whole thing. So for example, I want to limit only to see the data that has egg bacon flavor. So just put conditional here where flavor equal with egg bacon. Okay, and semicolon to end the SQL statement. I will execute here. Okay. So you might notice that I'm using a single quotation here. Single quotation is used to deal if the data is a text data or string data. So egg bacon is a text, it's not a numerical data. So in this case, I need to use the single quotation, or we can also use double quotation. But we have to be consistent. If we open with double quotation, we have to close it with double quotation. Okay, so you can use either double quotation or single quotation. Doesn't matter as long as we are consistent when we are using it. Okay, so and then as I mentioned before, we can also use oh yes, one more thing, because this is a string, we have to be exact. So for example, if I remove egg and I just want to say bacon, when I execute, it's nothing happened. Why? Because there is no flavor bacon. The flavor that we have in the table is egg space bacon. Egg bacon. So there is no bacon flavor only. So if we want to have some kind of flexibility when we are searching according or using text base, rather than using equal sign, we can use like sign. Okay, like only works with the text base. Okay, because in like, while we are using like, we can use percentage. So percentage mean anything. So in this case, percentage mean anything and then followed by bacon. Okay, whatever and followed by bacon, or anything and followed by bacon, for any text and followed by bacon. So if I execute, I can get egg bacon, because this one is something followed by bacon, match with this condition. Okay, or we can also use egg, so it means egg and then percentage. Yes, but when we use egg, we cannot use percentage in the front. Why? Because our data is egg bacon, not something egg, but egg followed by something. So if we use like this, it failed to find the data. Okay, so we can also use like this, bacon, sorry, bacon and then another percent. So it means that it contains bacon. Okay, and then as I mentioned before, we can also combine one or more condition. So for example, I want to get product code and flavor from products table that has flavor either bacon or almond. Bacon or almond, so I use or here. Okay, or flavor, like the flavor will contain almond, for example. Anything followed by almond, and then any text, and then put semicolon here. I will execute. Ta-da! Okay. So another condition that we can use is to represent a range. Okay, range. So to represent range, we can use between. Okay. So for example, like this. I will get another one. We'll use select. And then from, I will use table temperature. Temperatures here. And then I want to see temperature date and the temperature itself. Okay, so I will execute without where, just to give an idea about what kind of data that we have. Okay, like this. So for example, if we want to see only the data that has temperature between 25 to 27 degree 25 to 27, so we can use either like this. Okay, where the temperature, okay, must be greater than equal 25 if we want to include 25. Okay, and temperature less than or equal to 27. Or, so in this case, the data that has like temperature below 25 is not going to be retrieved, or the data that has temperature above 27 is not going to be retrieved in this case. So there is another statement that we can use if we don't want to use greater than and less than. To specify a range, we can also use between. Comment between 25 and 27, it will produce the same result but with simpler code and more concise. So yeah, it will generate, or it will produce the same result. Means that I want to fetch the data is temperature date and the temperature from table temperatures, and the condition is I want to get the data, the temperature data, which contains the temperature between 25 to 27 degree in this case. Okay, and there is another operator that you might have interest to learn, is in. Okay, in. So for example, I want to get the temperature which is 10, 20, and 30 degree. Okay. 10, 20, and 30 degree. So in this case, I'm gonna use in, and then follow by a list or a tuple. 10.0 for example, 20.0, and 30.0 for example. And then I will end it. Execute this one. Okay. In means I want to search only based on the list. In this case, I want to limit the data only the data that has temperature either 10 or 20 or 30. Okay, 10, 20, or 30. Okay, in is very similar with or. Okay, so if we use in, it's to simplify, and it will produce the same result as like this. Temperature equal with 10. 0, and then or temperature equal with 20.0, or temperature equal with 30.0. This is the same. Okay, this is the same. It will produce the same result. So You can do either like this. This is to limit only to get the temperature either 10 degree, 20 degree, or 30 degree. Okay. Or if you want to make it concise, rather than using three different or, we can simplify it using in, and then put the list of the temperature that we want to have, that we have interest in. In this case, we want to get the temperature date and temperature data from table temperatures where the temperature is in this list. If the temperature is not in this list, I don't want to see. So yeah, basically that's the meaning of this statement. Okay, the next statement as an addition, the next statement that we might want to learn is, this is all the example that we have been goes through. And the next clause that you might want to learn is order by. So order by is basically to show the data from a table sorted based on certain column. Okay, this is for sorting purposes. Okay, I'm gonna use the same case over here. Okay. And then if I want to sort it based on the temperature, I just use order by and then followed by the column that we want to sort by. Okay, order by temperature. Execute, so it will be order or sorted based on the temperature. Okay, so the list of the statement will be select and then from followed by where and then followed by order by. We cannot put order by before where. Okay, be very careful with the sequence of the keyword. Select first and then from and then where, and then if you want to put order by, we can put order by here. But if we don't have where, we can put order by just after from. Okay, so for example, if you want to do that, if we remove where, we still can be able to do this one. Okay. So it means that we want to see the whole data without any restriction in terms of temperature, but we want to sort it based on the temperature data. So it's sorted based on the temperature data. Okay. But if we have where, then the order by have to be after where. And then by default, order by will sort the data from the smallest one to the largest one. Okay, but we can also, or an ascending order, but we can also do it in a different way or in a descending order. We just put the keyword DESG to represent descending. Okay, execute, see, showing from the highest one to the lowest one. Okay, order by can also be used to sorting text data or non-numeric data. Okay, I will give you an example here. For example, I want to see select and then from table products, and then the things that I'm interested in is the flavor. Okay, I'm using like this only. Execute. These are all the flavor unsorted. Okay. If I want to sort the data, order by followed by flavor. Okay. So by default it will be sorted ascending from the smallest one to the highest one, alphabetical order. If I want to do reverse or descending order, can put DSG, descending like that, right? So yep. Okay guys, pretty much like this for this clip. So basically things that we have learned from this small clip is we learn about the SQL clause. So So the statement is select followed by the name of the columns from followed by the name of the table that we want in to see where followed by the condition. And in condition we have to put the we can use several different kind of operator here. Okay, this is highly mathematical operator to compare, or highly numerical operator to compare either it's equal, not equal, greater than, less than, and so on. And we can also use between to represent the range, like only works for text data, and in can be used to replace several row of or operator. Okay guys, so far like that. I will end this clip, and hopefully this clip is useful for you, and then see you next time in the next video. Have a good day.